Hi, once again, welcome to Food and Nutrition Diet. And if you're new to this channel, don't forget to subscribe, like, share with your friends. Now, in today's video, I've decided to talk about how to use themes in Holyrics. I'm going to take you step by step on how to create your themes and use them as backgrounds when you're displaying your words or anything on the projector. So let's go right to the video. Now, when you open Holyrics, on your right hand side, you can see here a word themes, and there are three dots here, as you can see. I want you to follow up my cursor so that you can understand better what I'm talking about. So you click here on where there are three dots, and they'll bring you such a box like this. There is a word create, settings, sort list, and bunch edit. So you go here to create if you want to create a new theme, or you can come here on your left hand side, and where there is a word new, you click here on new, and you go down on the second line where there is a word theme. That means that you're going to create a new theme. Or you can, when you're on your desktop, you can just control 2. They'll take you direct to such a screen which has themes to do what? The themes, where you're going to create your new theme. So let me go here to new, and I go to theme. And they will bring you such a screen. So when they have brought you such a screen, the first thing you should do is you come here to where there is a word change, and they will bring you such a table with as many things as this. So if you want your background or theme to be a color, you can choose any color from here, and let me say green. So that means that my background will be green. But there are other ways. There is this one also. These ones are backgrounds. Some of them already come with Holyrics, or others you just download them here. Like this one of Majesty already comes with Holyrics. Double click it, or you click there and you say okay. So that means that you're going to use this one here as your background. You see, Majesty as your background. Or you can just download them if you want to download them. Some of them I have already downloaded them, as you can see. I have this gray fresh, which all of them I've downloaded them. And here is another option of just patterns. You can also use, you see, there are as many patterns as you can see. You can use this to also do what, to also, you can also use this as your background. You just click there on the background which you want, and you click OK. We also have images here. These ones also come with Holyrics. They are free of charge. They already come with Holyrics, and I love this one so much. So you click on it. So the background, you can use that one as also a background. And here is where we have an option of my images, and the option of my videos. So my videos here, you can see that these videos do not come with Holyrics, but what you need to do is only one thing. You click here where there is the word click, and select a file and drag it upon here. So you come here and look for the background which you chose, the video which you chose, you have already done, and you want to use that as a background when you're going to display. You just choose, you double click on it, and the background, you will come here by itself. As you can see, my account here has come, but I downloaded these ones from the internet. So you can download anything, any video from the internet, and use it as a background here in Holyrics also with this option. And also images here, you can also download any image from the internet, and just come here, click, and choose one of the images you have downloaded from the internet, and use them as your backgrounds. So if you have many backgrounds, you can choose. And this one here gives you an opportunity to broadcast live when the words, when your words are down here. Let me just show you this. If you have cameras, you can connect it well and you display, as you're displaying the things on the camera and also displaying the what, the words they are singing, all the words they are representing on at your church. So you can see that my words will be down here, and the screen or the video which you are trying to broadcast will be up here. And let me just go here and I look for anything. I can just choose and I show you the rest of the part of Holyrics. Let me use this background here. So, and after this, you can also, there's another option here of options. So you can choose the color here which you want. Let me say that in this background here, or in this theme here, I want something like red in it. Let me say that red in it. I come here and I choose the color. Let me say red. And when I say red, then here, this is where I will change the opacity of how much you want. If you want it to be automatically red, it will be red like that. But let me put it as 50 as you, and you see. So you can see that there's some red in the background. And let's continue. Another thing is here, is where, here the first thing is fronts. How will your fronts appear? We know most of the cases we choose them, we choose this the background which people could see well. Let me choose, it is called Vendana. This one is the best background in most cases. So here is where I can also change the color of the words what do you want your color of the words to appear like. If you want your words to appear like green, you choose green. The words will be green on that background when you choose it. So if you want your words to be italic and bold, you can just choose from here. When they are bold and italic, you can see that they're somehow bent. If you don't want them to be italic, you just turn them like that. If you want, if you don't want them to be bold, you click here and they will not be bold. And most cases we use the bold because most of the people will not see the words very well if they are far away from the screen. So it is good to use the bold later most. And another thing is here where there is a spacing of the words. If these words, how much space do you want between the words? If you want 0.1, you can see that the words are so close together. And most cases we use 3 because the words will not be so far away from each other. But you can also put, you have an option of that, also 9, you can see. But let me use 3. And the spacing of the words between the word, these letters here, you can also add. And you see that the letters are what, are expanding how far away from each other, but it is easy to use at least 2 so that you can display it the way you want. And here you have another option of choosing where you want your words to appear, on the left hand side, in the middle, or on the right hand side, all of them to be full of the screen, in the whole screen. So we normally use this, but it is your option. You can choose anything you want because it's your option. Now you can choose the words to be start from up, or to be in the middle, or to be down. It will be on your option. So you can also choose to add a margin where your words should stop. Let me first add here and you see. You can also choose a margin from here. so. But it is normally at 3 so that things could appear well. Now we have other effects here. The outline of the words. If you want your outline to have the words to have some the outline, you can see that there's some black here. Let me say that I want the outline to be green, yellow. And when you choose yellow, let me say yellow. Let me choose yellow here. When you choose yellow, you can see that your outline will be some kind of yellowish. Let me put there 20 so that you can see that the yellow in it. So, and if you want your words to also be bright, you can also brighten here, but you can also choose the color of the brightness you want so that you can do what? You can brighten. You can see that my words are what? Are brightened. If you want your words to be brightened. And here is where you choose the shadow, where you want your shadow to what? To face. If you want it to face up, you can put it up. If you want it to face that side, you can put the shadow that side. And here is where you choose the color of the shadow. What color do you want your shadow to be in? Let me say that I want my shadow to be blue. And then you choose blue. That means that your shadow would be blue. But in most cases, we don't use this because it's not that what important. So let me just press here so that there will be no shadows. So if you want some blur in it, you can also add a blur. And we have here another option of a background color. If you want your background to also have another color when you're posting the words, that means that there will be something like a background, the color behind the words, and after the background, then behind the words there will be another color in it. Let me choose here in another color so that I can use as a background. Let me say blue. When I choose blue, you can see, and here is where you change the opacity. If you put it at 0, that means that it will not be seen. But if you put it at something like that, it will be shown like that. And here is where you change the spacing between the edge or margin between the words. You can see that as I reduce, you see that my color is also what? Reducing. And here is where you change where you want boxes or lines, something like that. You can see that if you want lines, that means that the color will fill the lines. If you want like that also, it will also happen like that. So here is that option, but in most cases we don't normally use this, so let me just remove it. But if you want it, you can choose it because it will be your display. And here is where another option of putting an outline on the words. So you can choose here the color of the outline which you want. Let me choose green. If you choose green, that means that the outline will be green. Then you can also change the opacity of the outline. You can also lower it down so that it cannot be seen, or it can be seen a little. So you can also change the width here of your outline. Put it at 25, you can see that it's somehow bigger. At 1, it is so thin. So you can also edit where you want your outline to be far away from the words, something like that. So, and here is where you can choose whether you want the outline to be in the words or in the box like that, or at the margin. Here is where you put a corner, whereby it will be, you putting such corners on your outline. This is what makes Holyrics to be so good, or the best app to use. You see that you can put pond corners in your outline. And here is where you can also add a moment, or what? Where you can also add a comment, but most cases we don't use this. That's why we don't normally recommend it. But if you want, you can also put there, and other settings are here. You can also set what you want to use here. And here you can also have if you want a wide screen, you can put a wide screen. If you want a standard one, if you have a standard screen, you can also choose like that. You change here the words which you want them to appear when, let me say that, let me write here a word, Jesus is Lord. That means that wherever I see this background, instead of appearing such words, the text which will appear will be Jesus is Lord when you have not yet used it. So after that, you come here and give it a name if you want. Let me give it a name. Jesus is Lord. Jesus is Lord. So, and after giving it a name, you can also add some tags here. But let me not add tags. And after that, you click save and exit. And after you have clicked save and exit, how you can display it. I have also other videos about how to write the songs or how to edit the words in Holyrics, and you can also subscribe so that you can be notified when I post a new video. So don't forget to subscribe because that is so important. So you can see that my background here I have chose is the what? Let me say that I have written my song. I have already written my song. So it is time to display. You can see that it will be displaying such a screen like this. The song. Mkwano kwange Yesu oyo musumba omulungi. So you can see that we are having our margin and the words in the middle and the background behind it. The background which we have just created. If this video has been important and of use to you, can you comment, like and subscribe? You leave your comments down here so that I can know whether I should add on, whether you have not understood very well, so that I can repeat for you a video, or I want to form a community of people who would share with me their views. So that's it for today. Thanks for watching.